Rockets, Alligator Video is a quick exploration of an extended first alien wave. Well, I'm going to explain to traders why the first wave sometime will be extended. What are the reasons why the first wave can be extended? This is a quick explanation of an extended first alien wave. Well, one of the reasons why the first wave can be extended is just due to the fact of the support and resistance levels that are ahead. So I'm looking at Liberty Global Incorporated stock, Class A stock. You can see here that I've done my homework, first mono wave, second mono wave, third mono wave, fourth mono wave, and fifth mono wave of the first wave. So from here to here, that's the first wave. I don't want the video to be too long. That's why I said a quick explanation to please the trader that want the video to be short. You see, it's an extended first wave. Then we have a second wave, a third wave, a fourth wave, and a fifth wave. As you can see here, the first wave has been extended, which means it's subdivided into five a man wave without any area wave violation. All right? So the first reason why you can expect a first wave extension like this, all right, is just due to the fact of the resistance ahead. So you see here, there's a resistance here. See, there's in fact a problem acknowledged. There's a resistance zone. Yeah, you see, price went up. I'm talking to myself, you see here. So you can see that the first mono wave of the first wave did break above that resistance level and was trying to retest it and pull back a bit here. That resistance, can you see that? Okay. Because the price going up, you see, the first one here, it went up, it acknowledged that resistance and then pulled back. Then this one again went up, that resistance, and pulled back. And because of those support and resistance ahead, sometimes this is just the first reason why you may end up having an extended first wave. See? Alright? See, this is another resistance here. You see, after the prior test, the previous resistance level, which resistance is the next one here. So now the third mono wave or the first wave tried to break above it and retest that resistance level. And if you look at the fifth mono wave or the first wave, it did try to go above this resistance here. Alright? So, first mono wave did break this resistance here, pull back this test. Third mono wave, the impulse waves are breaking resistance. See this one, try to break it. And the fifth wave, another impulse wave, also break the resistance. And look at this one now. The real second wave, try to retest this key level here, which is the previous resistance level. So if you start counting wave, one thing you can do to know where the corrective wave are likely to end, you can just draw the normal support and resistance level of the prior price action. So you see the price went up from here all the way here. Just draw all the support and resistance that you can see. So here it is, okay? Draw them. And then because that's what I'm saying to you, though we are using the area wave, we are trading the price. So see, went up. Resistance, people take profit, it pulled back. It went up, it was breakable, retest. Breakable, retest. There it is, okay? Just because of those key levels, support and resistance ahead, we end up having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 away. Probably, I'm not saying that's all. That is the only reason. I'm not saying that that is the only reason. But market was acknowledging those skills. Probably, if those resistance were not there, the prime makes spring from here straight away up there in one more up. But because of the resistance ahead, we end up having five more. This is one, not the reason. reasons. Another reason why the first wave can also be subdivided into five waves, apart from the fundamentals, is because of the fear. Right? People are afraid, you know, they are a bit hesitant. Right? So the first buyers are not that enthusiastic, they are careful, they are cautious, or they are a little bit afraid. Alright? And because of those of fear, you may also end up having a complex first wave. Or an extended first wave. You may say to me, this one is not very extended, sometimes it will be, that's another video, okay? So this is a quick explanation of an extended first wave, so I'll be recording more video to explain more of the extension of the first wave, alright? So the second reason, as I'll tell you now, is the fear. If you look at here, you can see that, you see this move here, so when people were here, probably, they were calling this one first wave, so they may call it trending first. At least. So from 2006 up to 2008, probably people who were here were saying probably this is the first wave, alright? Probably. Alright? Look what's happened. Now, the second wave that they were expecting and not the second wave ended up being counseling, okay, did counsel the first wave. So what's going to remind of those who were expecting a new trend here. So you can understand that we have the financial crisis in 2008 to 2009. So a lot of people are afraid now. So probably those people bought it here, or some people even bought it here, at the top right there, only to see it all the way down here. So now, as it starts going up, they are not very enthusiastic to buy, they are no more careless, they are more careful. So they buy here, they set their profit with the next resistance level. Alright? They take some profit, pull back, find the support, they buy again. They say, well, because of what has happened before, okay, we lost money, cancel it. I'm not going to use that approach anymore. I'll be more cautious. So they buy here, what is the next at the level? Next resistance level. They took some profit and pull back. By again here, they become very cautious, they are more afraid, they are no more careless before, because of the fear, they took profit again at the next resistance level. They pull back again, find support, they buy again, and then they take profit at the next resistance level. So, two elements to explain the extension of our first wave, which means first wave being subdivided into five minor waves, two major reasons. Resistance ahead or resistance or support ahead. So in a downtrend, it will be support levels. Right? In an uptrend, it will be resistance ahead or support below. Okay, can be the number one cause that will force, so to speak, the first wave to be subdivided into five, a specific five manual. Okay? Also, the second reason why. The first wave can be subdivided into five manner waves. It's just due to the fear. People are very careful and they are taking one step at a time and will end up having a complex first wave or a first wave that is subdivided into five manner waves. There are other reasons, for instance, if the market environment is not bullish, still it has something to do with fear, isn't it? Something to do with fear. Alright? Or the sector, people are hesitant, they are a bit careful about the sector, alright? And then they will be more cautious and that can also influence the first wave. So instead of having a real signature of the bull, like you see, up, you see here, this was nice move up without any subdivision. And now, look. Or a counsel. And people are more afraid, they are more cautious, they are more careful, they are no more careless. And that's why we may have, I'm not saying those are the only reason, but those are the two first reasons why you may have the first way that is subdivided into five way. All you can do, you are expecting the first way, you are expecting an impulse way, you can just take it one step at a time, and this one here,
Once upon a time, look at this one. After the turn with this hand, we look at that again. Alright? Take it, break the bow, it's resistant, then retest again. Okay. If you apply Fibonacci extension to this move, you will see the hidden resistance level, and the professional will acknowledge it again. If you measure also, oops, the depth of this kind of round button, kind of V pattern, yes or no? And we'll get it out. Let's see whether it takes some profit there also. It's a hidden resistance. What's going on here? Again, here. See the reaction there? The reaction here. One up, one down. Can't get the stick part. Invitation to buy right here. Okay, it's the same zone. Okay? So this will conclude this short tutorial about a quick explanation of an extended fresh fresh regime, support resistance level ahead, support ahead or resistance ahead or support below in a downtrend. And the second reason is just due to the fear, you are more cautious, you are more careful. If this video has been useful to you, please let us know by giving us a thumbs up. If you dislike it, please mark it down. If you think this is an essential tutorial, feel free to share with your friend on Google Plus, on Twitter, and also on Facebook. If you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel today and click on the notification bell, so anytime we record a new video, you will be the first person to be notified. Apologies to traders, let us know, my apologies to traders, about regarding this, the audio in the past, previous recording. Let me know whether it is improving now or not. Let me know in the comment section. It has something to do with Windows 10 update. Is that Windows 10? Alright. Let me know whether the audio has improved or not. So this will conclude our discussion today about a quick explanation of an extended fresh video. Until next time, enjoy yourself and be very happy. We are the TSTW, 24 traders. Happy day to you all, and I will speak to you soon. The financial instrument that we analyze today is a Liberty Global Incorporated. First way, so divide it into five other ways. Second way, third way, fourth way, and then a fifth way. We expected a zigzag correction. That's an expectation. It's not a guarantee. It's not a certainty. We will see whether we have our orderly zigzag pattern. The price is finding a support now in the zone of 50% to 61.8% level, which is normal because of the retracement of the second way. We can use the retracement of the second way to forecast the correct here. So there are people buying here. But if you break below that sweet exposure zone, there's a high chance that we may have a zigzag pattern bringing it a little bit more down. Be aware that there are people buying here at this junction.